Mateo told us about your pilgrim's voyage.
You found it, didn't you? The meaning of unity. Wait, say that again? Multiple universes?
You can't possibly mean what I think you mean.
Yes, I wouldn't mind a little more detail. I don't even want to think about the physiological changes you'd need to travel between universes. Plus what it would do to the mind? Enlightenment? Or oblivion? Like the Hunter.
You have the opportunity to reach the closest thing to your god that might exist. And you're second-guessing it?
One doesn't approach the afterlife without some trepidation. You're right. This is a lot to take in.
Not to make a sharp turn in a grand tale, but I got the eye fixed up. Bruised, but still blinking. Let me know when you're ready to follow up on what it's seen. These last glimpses from the eye are from the farthest fringes of known space. Could be the only remaining pieces outside the hands of the Starborn. Aye. The blackest sea seems less of a concern when there are sharks leaping out at you. Catch a smile out there.
About your life will be made into a movie? And who do you think will play me?
Profit is never necessarily the aim, but something. That we are here, what will be our next course of action?
Constellation has been collecting a ton of new things. Ancient.
Thank you. research station. You speaking. What is your business here? What? We haven't sent a distress signal. Nothing on the comms. No other ships in the system since our last supply drop. Look, what are you trying to pull here? Really? The High Energy Research Lab? All right. I don't know what's going on here, but you should talk with the director. For security, I'm going to have to ask your friend to wait out there. What's inside? Stay with me, and don't make any sudden moves. I'll get the door. Welcome, Tunisia.
It seems a strict policy, but in a way that is reassuring. Suggest they know what they are doing. Do not worry about me. Go ahead and go.
Ethan Hughes, Chief of Security. If you'll follow me, I'll show you to the director. We'll take the back way up. Here, you can see our lovely storage area. Don't touch anything. So, Nishina was
what the? Easy! Easy! What the hell was that?
You can explain.
Explain what? I should have never let you inside. What is this? Some kind of stealth tick? Who are you working for? What? That's... How do you know?
All right. I'll take you to the director. But I am watching you.
Come on, this way.
Who's there? Oh, oh, thank God. Finally, someone came. The distress signal. You picked up the distress signal, right? It's been so long. I'm out of food, out of water. But I made it. Wait, how did you get in here? Your... what? That doesn't...
Sophia! We should... Wait. He's back. All right. We're on our way up. Hughes out.
I was just filling in the director. Let's keep moving.
If anything happens, the director's office is on the second floor, end of the hall. You can't miss it.
Thank you.
This way. Director?
Thank you, Ethan.
Come in. Kaya Patel, Research Director.
And this is our Chief Scientist, Maria Hughes.
Ethan said you disappeared right in front of him. Twice now? Three times?
Director, you can't be taking this seriously. Look, I don't know who you are or what you're doing here, but there has to be a rational explanation for all of this. No, I can't wait to hear this. Our experiment? If the probe is feeding power into the distortion, then...
What have we done? The source of the distortion? We don't know what it is, but clearly you do. An alternate universe?
That's ridiculous. The accident? How could you know?
All right.
Director?
Enough. I don't know who or what you are, but you clearly know more about this than we do. Maria, take our guest to your lab and do whatever he needs you to do.
Come with me. The control unit is in the fabrication lab next door. What have we gotten ourselves into?
you. What happened? You disappeared, and the ceiling caved in, and... I thought I'd finally lost it. You mentioned that before. You said you were shifting to another universe? I don't understand any of this. If I hadn't seen you disappear with my own eyes, I wouldn't have believed it. Okay. You're my ticket out of here. We'll do this your way. We can get out through the pantry. Here's the key. I'll back you up, I guess.
What the?
Security breach!
Joe,
everybody
go.
Out!
Look at this. It's going to take hours to clear this out. Assuming the rest of the building doesn't come down on top of us. How should I know? You're the one who keeps winking in and out of existence. I just want to get out of here. Go do whatever you're going to do. I'll see if I can clear a path to the door. I'm not sure. It might stop whatever's happening to you. It's a reasonable theory, I guess. They're a native species. We had an electric pulse field to keep them out. The fire took out the generators, damaged the foundation. They just keep coming. I was in the lab, working on the frequency calibration for the probe. I was walking out of the control room when it happened. I heard the tank's rupture. The alarm sound. I only had a second to react. I jumped back into the control room. The doors sealed. I was safe. From the gas, the fire, everything. But I was trapped. There was nothing I could do to stop it. If I had gone the other way, maybe I could have made it to the ventilation controls. Killed the system. Even if it killed me, I don't know. I don't want to think about it.
It's you. You realize you just poked into my locked office. So much for security protocols. Sure. Down the hall. Take the stairs next to the atrium. Yeah. Let me get the doors for you. And done. Is there anything else you need? The Kataxi in the other universe. Uh-huh. Wow. I've got an experimental thing one of the engineers put together. But... Not happening. You really don't have anything better to do? Maybe we can work something out. That's what I'm hoping. Yeah, I hope so. All right. Yeah. It's never been field tested, but all yours. Yes, Kataxi. Nasty things. The original survey team ran across them. You're welcome to read the old logs if you want. Yeah, I'll unlock the terminal for you. Bigger than you'd expect. We've got a particle accelerator, whole lab complex, the high energy research lab. Real state of the art. Can't tell you what a tenth of it actually does. That's right. Has been since the accident. We can't connect to the control system to override it. The whole system's on a hair trigger. Cameras spot anyone not in the staff database. They fire off an alarm and all hell breaks loose.
Thank you. What, did you get lost in the hallway?
I hope you know what you're doing.
All right.
Calibrating to 89 teravolts.
What the?
It's a micro distortion. Flux pattern matches the distortion in the lab. The setting is just exposing it somehow. Step into the distortion, please. All right, whatever you say. All right, stay there. Let me turn the feedback up for a moment. Calibrating to 90, 91. What happened? Are you all right? Right. Of course you did. If you can get down to the research level, you need to make your way to the high-energy research lab. Disengage the power interlocks, then pull the emergency shutdown to stop the probe. That should finally put an end to all this. Oh, and before you go, the director wanted to speak with you. It really is just down the hall.
All set? If you need supplies, I've asked Dr. Barakova to take care of you. It's the least I can do after everything we've put you through. Before you go, there is one other thing we should discuss. If this experiment is the cause of your shifting, when you shut it down, the shifting will stop. What happens then? To you and to us. Then the question is, what will you choose? Of course. I don't know. I'm not sure it's possible to know. It may cease to exist. It was one possible universe, but not what actually happened. We or Raphael actually did die months ago. Or it may remain real. Just not in your universe. Or in some quantum sense, perhaps you make both choices and both outcomes will be real. Welcome to quantum mechanics. Nothing will change. Nothing can change. If the universe was other than it was, you would not be here to make this choice. What you choose will be what happened in your universe, the universe that brought you to this point. If this were a choice between my life and Raphael's, I would ask you to save him. But as the director of the station, I am responsible for the lives of my staff. 30 people, People with families, careers, futures ahead of them. In this universe. Not that I can see. Have you reached a decision? It's not an easy decision, but I am grateful. Thank you. Now, it's time you are going. With the network offline, we can't shut down the security system on the research level, so you can expect some resistance. Be careful. Ethan, unlock the elevator lobby, please.
Ma'am, research level is still locked down.
I'm aware of that.
All right. Done.
Good luck, dear. It's been a fascinating day. Excuse me.
Tatiana Barakova, station's doctor. This is not a public medical facility, but the director has ordered me to assist you nonetheless. I can spare a few med packs. Beyond that, I am not your therapist, your psychologist, or your cosmetologist. If there's anything else you need, ask. My journal? Have you been in my quarters? Who do you think you are? The director may have given you run of this station, but I... Wait. Wait. What is this? This entry. It's mine, but... I didn't write this. And the scorch marks. God. Yes. Yes, I do. I can spare a few more supplies. And I'll give you a break on anything else you need. Let me see what I can find. I would have thought you were tougher than that. Fine. Have a seat. Have a seat. There.
override controls are available on designated security terminals. lockdown is active. Emergency override controls are available on designated security terminals.
Yes. Thank you.
You're back. I wasn't sure if you were alive or... or if you were going to come back for me. I mean, not that I'm not grateful, but... why? Why not stay in that other universe? Yeah, I do. It's not much, but I scrounged up a few things you might still be able to use. You're welcome to anything else you find lying around, too. No one's going to miss it. And as for me, I owe you. You ever need an engineer, just say the word. Now, let's get off this damn rock.
If you are free soon, could we talk?
Here to shoot the breeze?